Israel's ready for a giddy post-pandemic party. Crowding cafes, filling Jerusalem's old market.
We're back to life. Like, you can see all the people going around.
We have a fever in the last week.
Celebrating a vaccination drive that's inoculated more than half the population in record time and an infection rate that's tumbled. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu is taking credit for that.
We're coming out of it, and there's not much more.
He's led Israel for 15 years now, longer than anyone else, winning elections or eking out coalitions. This time, he's also on trial for corruption, charges which could mean jail if he doesn't hold on to power. If he does, he could potentially pass new laws to give himself immunity. Netanyahu's banking on Israel's gratitude for defeating COVID. But polls show many voters are tired of him, and that even with right-wing allies, his Likud party may not have enough to form a coalition government. Challengers from Israel's secular center and its religious right are catching voters' attention.
We need a change. We need something new and refreshing.
Netanyahu's claim of a vaccination victory may not be winning them over.
I think what it really does is make people who were already voting for Netanyahu feel more strongly about it, and those who were already voting against him feel more passionately about it.
Leaving Israel, happy to move on from COVID, but seemingly set for another unstable coalition government. Sasha Petrusik, CBC News, Toronto.